The Honorable Governor, sir, will request you to get up once more and request you for your address.
My greetings to everyone here. It's an honor, a privilege, a moment to cherish for me. And I know in this program, I will have much, much to take home that will show me light, that will give me a direction, that will motivate me, and that will energize me, increase my strength. Honorable Dr. S.P. Kanodia ji, Megha has been a little unfair to me. I wanted to greet the man by using that title, Happiness in the Age of Ambition. She has stolen a slogan that I wanted to give to the great man whose life stands on the pillar of spirituality. But congratulations to Megha, Happiness in the Age of Ambition. An excellent title that says all. I would have read this book in next 24 hours. And we'll get back to the author. Hemant and Sunil and their two other brilliant brothers, they have carried the torch in the right earnestness. They have made their family and father very proud. That is the true culture and spirituality. In the city of joy, as the first foot soldier, as governor of the state of West Bengal, I welcome everyone who is from outside the state. You are at a place that is cultural confluence of India, if not of the world. But it's a challenge to any such destination in the world, and I'm sure we'll have a place of pride. Another significant aspect is this place is authentic home of spirituality. Young, energetic artists, participants, ladies and gentlemen, when I was greeting the young performers and giving the prizes, there came a gentleman. He said, I'm the only man. I was reminded what the Israeli Prime Minister said of Golda Meir when she was not the Prime Minister, but was only a minister. She became Prime Minister later on. And the Prime Minister of Israel said, the only man in my cabinet is a woman. The good part of this foundation, about which people far more taller than me in achievement and life have reflected, is harmonious mix of both the genders in effective contribution. And that's a delightful experience. I'm slightly outnumbered in my small family by the other gender. And I'm sure the First Lady will take some hint out of it. I'm happy to be here at this valedictory session. And this happens to be continuously 12th in a line. And when I saw the background, my place was shown. Tallest of leaders, politicians, statesmen had been here. I have a lot to learn from them. I am really inspired, motivated, and I thank the foundation for this historic opportunity to me. I must congratulate everyone who has taken the initiative of building such Bharat and such Vishwa. As a matter of fact, our entire culture of 4,000 years. We slightly had lost way somewhere else, reflects this. I'm so glad it is being enlivened by that part of the society which normally does not emotively focus on this. In financial terms, business community has been contributing. I salute the business community. Our concept of corporate social responsibility, a commendable job is doing, job has been done. But spirituality, if that is the focal point, well, I'm sure salutations are to be there. They are well deserved, eminently deserved. I'm sure everyone who has come here and everyone who is present here gets the feel of what spirituality is. People these days are in search of spirituality. And that is gaining great momentum. Initially, about 4 years back, I only have a daughter, my son-in-law said, he is spiritually interested. In a sense, being a professional in law, I thought, what does that mean? How does it help you make more money? I was automatically stumped. And I was stumped, you know when? When another great lawyer for whom I have great respect came to call on me. A giant of the bar, my son-in-law and that great lawyer, they were talking about spirituality, meditation, and ignorant Jagdeep Dhankhar was only looking at them. Then I came to know spirituality has something which is not available anywhere else. It is, if I put it in practical medical terms, it is not an X-ray. It is not CT scan. It is not an MRI. It is far superior to that MRI. And therefore, the problems that we have in the world today, greatest of the leaders are focusing on them, right from the climate change, right from disruption of peace, right from taking to violence on every small cause. Trust me, I have remembered Gandhiji more in his 150th year on account of his spirituality than on any other count. I am an infant when it comes to spirituality. I have virtually admitted to this august group 4 years ago. I thought spirituality was just a word to be talked about to put yourself on a higher pedestal in the highly urbanized society. It's a practical, it's a reality. Go to any village in India, because over these 4 years, I have been very focused. And that is amazing. I'll give you two illustrations. Why? Because this is being spearheaded by business world, business community. A businessman who had made great money, and the chartered accountant dealing with the corporate world said, there is no problem for 8 generations. The 8 generations in a row, even if they take tangential route, which is unwholesome, funds will last. But then there is a problem for the 9th generation. Grand old man was worried. How to take care of the 9th generation? So he went to a Panditji and took the chartered accountant along with. Panditji looked at the great businessman. Suddenly at the door of a pandit, there was a knock. And someone came. Those who are from India, Bharat, they would know about it. Shraddh. They got some food for him. Those who are from outside, a cooked meal was being brought for Brahmin family. And the Panditji said to his wife, Bhagwan, koi siddha laya hai. And you know what the Bhagwan said, the wife of the Pandit? Apne to ek aa gaya, isko kahin aur bhej do. Mind you, the businessman was worried about the ninth generation. And she was not worried about the next meal. That is spirituality. Those were good old days when every atithi in a family was a welcome guest. So a saint knocked a house in deep summer. The lady of the house opened the gate and found he is in need of water and food. She gave him food, she gave him water. And thereafter she got little kinder. And she moved little ahead and packed something for her, for him. You know what was the response of the saint? No. Things will take care of themselves. He left. That is spirituality. Spirituality does not want power from somewhere else. It has to come from within. You will find in every office, I have seen it, in every government office, is aadmi ka koi jawab nahi hai. Ye apne dimag se kaam karta hai. He may not be a decision maker. He may be class 4. He may be class 3. Spirituality resides in him. Spirituality creates that kind of impregnability which even an army cannot destroy. That gives you happiness, not in body, not in mind, but in totality. I am therefore in a delightful situation that on this aspect, which has to be felt, to understand it, you have to feel it. Lack of spirituality can create a great void in your life. It can make you lose direction. And that will impact, someone had said rightly, 3 next generations. And therefore, a sense of spirituality has to be inculcated. It can't be indoctrinated. It can't be taught. It has to be imbibed. It has to be imbibed in a subtle sense, with full sublimity, in an imperceptible manner. And I have no doubt, when a nation rises as a spiritual power, well, it goes at top of the world. Bharat was Vishwaguru only on one count, its strength of spirituality, power of its meditation. If our saints had been to those gufas, they were in search of that essence that takes us close to godliness. I am therefore indebted to this foundation. I was looking at their magazine yesterday night, talked to 4 gentlemen, 2 of them being my predecessors in office, and they were unanimous. Jagdeep, you need to go to that place. You will come as a stronger governor. You will not have to be in adversarial mode. You will never get dejected. You will never get frustrated. You will never be deterred by the opposition that is not very rational. And you will always be open to correction. If you are involved with spirituality, you have the courage immediately to own your lapse, to learn from it, to take it forward. On an issue, there was a well-scripted speech, but having seen two things here, the pristine, authentic approach of everyone present and the two authors and the people who performed, I thought, let me not use my mind, let me not go through the script, let me say something ad hoc, extempore, out of my heart. I have revealed my heart. I congratulate the other author, Manisha ji, also. I'm yet to read the book, but the title of the book says it all, and that is Aspire to Inspire. I cannot help saying something that slightly goes in my favor, but I'm moved by these two captions that I'm saying so in a compulsive manner, and everyone here will take it not indicative of any arrogance. When, as a union minister, 30 years ago, I called on the celebrated author, Kamar Natwar Singh, a diplomat, a parliamentarian, an author of repute, straightway from Raj Bhavan, Rashtrapati Bhavan. Raj Bhavan occurs a little too frequently for me. I'm residing there at the moment. Rashtrapati Bhavan, I went to his place. He gave me a book and wrote two things. Be the object and subject of your community. He meant a lot. I will commend to all of you one book which I read 2 years ago. Not exactly on spirituality, but very close to it. That is Untethered Soul. We find justification for our situations to our subjective satisfaction by imagining a fact situation that is non-existent. Spirituality will clear that air. It will help us see us effectively in mirror. And in the state of West Bengal, if you love to be a painter or a kavi, it can be rewarding from several ways. Ek baat keh sakta hoon. Spirituality par dhyan dene ke baad, aapka aina aapse kabhi aapki pehchan nahi puchhega. Namaskar.
Thank you so much, sir. That was truly spoken from the heart. Thank you once again.